Penang Bridge is the 13.5km bridge linking Penang Island with the rest of Peninsula. Opened in 15th of September 1985, the 6-lane bridge creates a permanent connector across Strait of Penang, encouraging economy, social activities and tourism. Also, there was a suggestion to name the bridge as Seri Penang Bridge or Mutiara Penang Bridge when the bridge was under construction. What are the reasons to build a long bridge across the strait into an island with high construction costs? Let's drive on the cable stay bridge and understand of the history and importance of Penang Bridge. Penang is historically prospered from the sea route thanks to its strategic location between Singapore and Bay of Bengal and its harbour location protected from the open sea. With the combination of increasing population, increasing household income that led to affordability to own a vehicle and subsidized petrol, makes the land vehicles took over sea vessels as the main mode of local transport. Thus, until the late 20th century, ferry is a crucial as a connector between Penang Island and the rest of Peninsula. Before Penang Bridge was built, ferry becomes the crucial vessel carrying pedestrians and vehicles. The introduction of the iconic double-decker ferry in 1959 increased the capacity of the ferry service. The combination of the increase of population and number of vehicles caused the ferry to stretch its capable operation to serve the increasing number of passengers and vehicles. As the vehicle queue for the queue start outside the ferry terminal and overflowed, causing congestion in the main roads in Georgetown. Ferry terminal located at Georgetown are surrounded by historic shops and buildings, and the ferry terminal on the Perai side is surrounded by industrial area, already congested areas. Massive queues up to 5km was common and become worse during the major holidays and school holidays. In addition, certain heavy vehicles are not allowed to use the ferry due to safety concerns, such as oil tanker and lorries carrying flammable goods. As a result, there were suggestions and ideas to build a bridge linking Georgetown on the island side and Perai on the mainland side. However, due to exorbitant cost, exorbitant price and available technology at that time is not adequate enough, so the suggestion to build a bridge remained a suggestion. Initially, it was feared that the new bridge might lead to eventual closure of the beloved ferry service. The reasons: crossing the strait using ferry is nearer and quicker during off-peak hours for the drivers from Northern Penang and Sungai Petani. Meanwhile, pedestrians are not allowed to walk on the bridge. I talked about the history of the Penang Ferry in a previous video where the ferry service remained popular even after the completion of the Penang Bridge. The link to watch this video will be appeared. The suggestion to link Penang with the mainland has been appeared in the written form since 1973. Due to high cost and technological limit, the plan was postponed until the late 1970s, where there were enough financing and technology to construct such a bridge. In the planning stage of the project, the bridge was initially called as Hubungan Pulau Penang Tanah Besar or Penang Mainland Link. Initially, the bridge was planned to build between Perai and Bayan Lepas via Jeraja Island, further south than the current bridge location and midway to the second Penang Bridge. Okay, where is the source of this information? It was based on the Parliamentary Hansard, Malaysian Parliamentary Hansard, dated 9th of April 1981. Penang Bridge was built as part of the grand plan to link the major cities on the west coast of Peninsula, albeit with different contractor and different concessionaire until PLUS took over its concession. Together with the development of building a dual carriageway between Bukit Kayu Hitam on the Thai border with Johor Bahru near Singapore border, the Penang Bridge project was planned as part of the Grand Dois National Project. I talked about the earliest part of the North-South Expressway, also known as PLUS in Malaysia, in the previous video, where the expressway was initially planned as just an improvement of the existing Federal Route 1, just a double carriageway with traffic lights and U-turns. To watch this video, the link is here. By 1977, the government has incorporated Syarikat Jambatan Pulau Pinang Berhad or Penang Bridge Sdn Bhd with a capital of 300 million ringgit, a huge sum of money at that time. The eventual decision to build a bridge to an island without significant natural resources are these three: state capital, industrial park, and airport. First, Georgetown, the state capital of Penang, is located on the island side and the largest city in the state. In fact, the whole island is under the municipality of Georgetown. State capital generate huge amount of traffic, civil servant, contractors, people who want to run errand in a government office, meetings, event, and so forth. Therefore, ferry service is not enough to carry all the passengers and vehicles across the street during the rush hour when the ferry is operating within 20 minutes frequency. Second, industrial park. The establishment of Bayan Lepas Industrial Park attracted foreign investors, specifically in electric and electronic sector, high-tech stuff. As living on the mainland is cheaper due to lower housing costs, people are willing to brace the traffic crossing the street for the sake of extra money for their family. Thirdly, the expansion of Penang International Airport. With the expansion of the airport completed in 1979, Penang International Airport is the main gateway to the northern part of Peninsula at the main regional airport. Penang served by major regional cities such as Singapore, Bangkok, Medan and Hong Kong, which makes transit to Kuala Lumpur less necessary. With its 3,300-meter runway, it is capable to handle large aeroplanes, making Penang one of the airports serving the route to Jeddah during Hajj season. As you might can able to guess, the combination of government buildings, industrial areas and an international airport generate a lot of traffic. Therefore, a bridge was needed as the ferry is no longer sufficient to carry the increasing number of vehicles crossing the street. In 1982, the construction of building the third longest bridge in the world at that time was officially began. The construction duration to build the 13.5 km bridge is 3 years and 3 months with a cost of 850 million ringgit. As a comparison, KL Seremban Highway, built with full control access with a length of 80 km, opened in 1982, was built with a cost of 90 million ringgit. Together with the bridge, a highway was built between Penang Bridge and Georgetown to bypass Jalan Sultan Azlan Shah that have numerous intersections and traffic lights, the highway known as Tun Dr. Lim Chong Yu Highway today. When the bridge was under construction, there were several issues that have been raised, for example, compensation to the landowners, diversion of the shipping route, the future of the renowned ferry service, and even the reduced harvest of the shellfish due to construction tailings. Before the completion of the bridge, the official name of the project is Penang Bridge. According to the Parliamentary Hansard dated 18th of July 1985, there are suggestions to name the bridge as Seri Penang Bridge, Mutiara Penang Bridge or even Buah Penang Bridge. When the bridge was officially opened on 15th of September 1985, it was the third longest bridge across the water in the world after Lake Pontchartrain Bridge and Chesapeake Bay Bridge Tunnel, both located in the US, which makes Penang Bridge the longest bridge across the water outside United States on its completion. It was projected that 22,000 vehicles were expected to use the bridge after its completion. The bridge reduced the time taken to cross Straits of Penang from 25 minutes by ferry, not including queue time, to just 10 minutes, not including queue time at the toll plaza. Penang Bridge encouraged economic growth as more vehicles are able to cross the strait and encourage the tourism industry. It is possible to drive directly from Kuala Lumpur to Georgetown for a plate of nasi kandar. For those people who know or have heard of the concept called induced demand, adding more roads have predictable consequences on the traffic volume. Induced demand could define as the increase of supply with the reduced cost will lead to increase of demand. As Penang Bridge increased the efficiency of driving against using the ferry and bus, the demand of private vehicles increased as well. The impact of increasing traffic on the island was felt even in the first year of Penang Bridge operation. In 1985, 19,336 vehicles used Penang Bridge on October compared to 24,201 vehicles by ferry in the same month. By December 1985, 32,577 vehicles used Penang Bridge compared to 23,875 vehicles on the same month. The bridge has exceeded the projected daily traffic of 22,000 vehicles daily, average daily, in just 3 months. Therefore, it is common to face traffic congestion on the bridge, especially during the peak hours as people rush to the workplace on the island side. With the opening of Sungai Nibong Bus Terminal in the year 2005, the island is connected to the Peninsula Express Bus Network, reducing the importance of ferry and increase the traffic on the bridge as well. Before the Penang Bridge was built, the express bus could go as far as a ferry terminal in Butterworth. By the mid-2000s, the increasing average daily users of Penang Bridge caused the call for expansion of the bridge. As a result, the construction of the additional two more lanes was started in the year 2005 with a cost of 470 million ringgit. The additional lane for each direction was added on the lower part of the bridge. The upper part, including the cable stay part, is already built with three lanes per direction. Additional lanes construction is a challenge by itself. New pillars and piling activities were done near the existing pillars with active traffic using the bridge. As one bridge is not enough, the second bridge with 24 kilometers in length was mooted and eventually built between 2008 until 2014. Second Penang Bridge, officially known as Sultan Abdul Halim Muazzam Shah Bridge, was opened to traffic on 2nd of March 2014. In addition to vehicular traffic, Penang Bridge carried electric cables and crews for a day during annual Penang Bridge Marathon, the only time the bridge would be closed to traffic. Have you ever travelled on the Penang Bridge? You can comment down below. If you want to drive on Penang Bridge, the bridge connecting Glugor on the island side and Perai on the mainland side. From the mainland, the bridge is accessible via North-South Expressway for vehicles from Kuala Lumpur and the cities throughout the Plus network. From the island, Penang Bridge is accessible via Lim Chong Yu Highway and Jalan Sultan Azlan Shah, the old road linking Jelutong and Bayang Lepas. The toll is RM5.74 for Class 1 vehicles, which is cars, and only charged island-bound. The mainland-bound trip is free. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something new about Penang Bridge as the crucial link between Penang Island and the rest of Peninsula. Thank you so much for watching again and see you in the next video.